Good evening, dear students. I, Dr. Asad, welcome you all to this video lecture session of Hope English Language Center, Satellite Town, Quetta. And in this class, that is level advanced, our today's topic of discussion will be techniques of teaching. As after passing out from this class, most of you people will be, inshallah, bright teachers. So in order to be acceptable teachers, you'll have to act upon these techniques or tips. So be very attentive. There will be about three videos on this topic, that is technique of teachings. So try to just watch them all in order to get the concept quite perfectly. So be with me for about 45 minutes. Of course, not a single video will be of 45 minutes. There will be three videos each of 15 minutes. Got it? So before moving to my actual topic, I would like to tell you people something regarding this profession, that is teaching. It is one of the noble professions of the globe, but being a tough job, that is transferring knowledge from brain to brain, it is also considered as the toughest jobs of the earth, planet earth. So you'll have to act upon certain tips, techniques and tricks in order to be extraordinary or attractive or colorful teacher, that is, which your students shall accept you, and you shall be, for example, pondering on each and every angle. You must be informed of the psychology of your students. So in this topic, I have not included the psychology of students. Of course, it is quite a long and interesting topic, and in my next videos you'll be inshallah seeing that topic as well. So let's start from this initial topic, that is 5 P's. So as I told you that all of the students are having their own we can say reflection of their minds regarding their different teachers, and most of the time they are titling or they are declaring some teachers as good and others as unacceptable in a sense. So if you want to prove yourself a good teacher, so you shall act upon these tips or techniques. So among these tips, the first one is 5 P's. What do you mean by 5 P's? That is, there are 5 P's, that is first, second, third, fourth and fifth. So each and every P is standing for a specific topic or for a specific term. That is, first P is planning, second is preparation, third is presentation, fourth is practice, and finally production. So what does it mean, that is planning? The initial P, that is planning, means that if you are, for example, presenting any topic, you shall plan for that. For example, tonight I planned that techniques of teaching will be my topic of discussion in this class, that is level advanced. So I just planned for this topic. So this was my first step, and I'm trying to prove myself an attractive teacher. So this is planning. Whenever you are planning for any topic, any for example discussion in your class, you shall be having the entire material with you. You shall be having perfect examples, informations, facts and figures regarding your topic in order to make it more attractive. So planning is the first step, and this is also one of the we can say terms, we can say we can just use this in a sense of collection of data. First you are thinking that you shall teach techniques of teaching, for example. So you'll have to collect the entire data from electronic media, for example, from book sources, from hard and soft copies, got it? So after that collection, so the process of collection is actually your planning, and you are sitting, and then you are moving towards preparation. So once when you are done with the data, when you have collected enough data on this topic, that is technique of teaching, then you will have to sit and make yourself a student. As they say that a good teacher is a very good student during night. Got it? That is, he or she is preparing for his or her class. So you'll have to prepare this planned data, or you'll have to prepare for your class. This is next P. Okay, then comes a presentation. Presentation can be given in different, we can say, manners, different modes. So you can just give the presentation of your topic to your younger or elder brothers, to your family members, or you can simply just give presentation of your topic in front of the mirror. You just stand in front of the mirror, and after that, just watch your body language, watch your, for example, pronunciation, watch your words, got it? That how much you are, we can say, proving yourself a good teacher or a colorful teacher, got it? So this is presentation. So after, for example, after preparation, initial was planning, that is P1, then comes preparation, P2. Third is presentation, as I told you, P3. So after that, you can just, for example, find out or figure out, or in other words, fish out the drawbacks in your presentation or in your topic. Then you'll have to work on that. So this is presentation. You'll have to present that topic. Got it? This is the third P. Then comes fourth P. It stands for practice. So after presentation, try to practice that on daily basis. If you are presenting topics, you'll have to, for in your initial days of teaching, of course, not for the lifetime. So you'll have to practice your topic. So by practice, I mean presentation. It is also one of the forms of presentation. So you'll have to practice that. You'll have to write the important points. You'll have to present that again and again. We call it practice. Got it? Okay, then comes the final P, that is production. Okay, production is something which is not concerned with you. Of course, it is the product of your efforts, but it is something you'll have to achieve from others. That is, by production, I mean, if you are presenting any topic quite, we can say, perfectly or in a very attractive manner, then you'll get the output, or the product in the form of questioning and answering your question answer session of your class, in the form of different, for example, motivational terms from your director, from your boss, and in the form of, for example, very beautiful suggestions from students, which is given in that suggestion box, or which is in suggestion box of that language center. Got it? So production is the fruit. It is actually the fruit of your efforts. So once when you are presenting any topic quite perfectly, then you will be actually having the production in the form of responses, output from the students. Got it? So these are the five important P's. You'll have to consider all these. And if you are acting on them, we can say, in a sincere manner, you will be, inshallah, a very good teacher. Got it? So that is planning, preparation, presentation, practice, and production. Got it? So these are the five P's. This is the very initial technique of teaching. Now let's come to next technique. The next is technique or trick is that first specify, then generalize. This is quite an important one. You might have seen certain teachers in your life that they are presenting a topic, they are having data, they are quite informative, and they are quite hardworking and intelligent, but they cannot convey the message or the topic towards the students. So then the students are saying that he or she is not a good teacher. Got it? So of course they'll be coming up with the ugly comments. So over here, first specify, then generalize means that you'll have to make a map of your topic. You'll have to make an outline of your topic. By outline, I mean that the map, that what are you about to teach your students. If from the very initial minutes of your class, the students are, for example, quite confused, or they are their brains are scattered, or their thoughts are scattered, that what are we supposed to learn today. So you will be, of course, never titled as a good teacher. So you'll have to first specify your topic that today I am teaching you the techniques of teaching. What is teaching? Who is teacher? What are their pros and cons? And so on. Got it? So first specify. Okay, this is making the outline. After that, generalize. Generalize means that then start your topic. Got it? Okay, over here in specification, there is a term we call it organize. Organize. To put the things on the right place. Got it? What do you mean by organize? You might have heard of people, or we can say that organized people. So organized people are those who are putting the things or the stuff on their relevant places. For example, you can just take the example of a room. Most of people are quite messy regarding their arrangement of stuff in the room. But most of other people, they are perfectionists. They are quite disciplined. Got it? They need each and everything on their place. So organization means that when you are specifying the topic, when you are giving the ideas to students that, for example, today we are about to study these three, for example, techniques. First technique is 5 P's. Second technique is first specify, then generalize, and finally comes important points. Got it? So these are the, for example, then you shall just, we can say generalize it. That 5 P's mean these, and first specify, then generalize these topics actually means, for example, XYZ, whatsoever. Got it? So get organized or move organized in order to, we can say, you shall not, we can say, the feedbacks from the students shall not come that we are lost in this topic. Got it? You shall never hear this comment from your students that, we are lost in your topic, or sir, we are not understanding it. Got it? So for that, you'll have to first specify, then generalize. Okay, then comes next important points of teaching. That is ego, feeding, and appreciation. These are quite important points. Got it? And you shall be acting on these points. Got it? In your later lives, inshallah. And it will be proving that you might have, for example, acquired quite important knowledge in today's lecture. So what are important points in teaching? That is ego, feeding, and appreciation. First important point regarding teacher, of course, is that echo, sound or voice echo. You might have seen certain teachers in your lives that they are quite good teachers, but they are lacking the quality of, we can say, strong, or we can say thundering sound. A good sound, or we can say a voice that is heard quite clearly, or a sound that is refreshing, got it, is playing quite an important role in, for example, building up or constructing good teachers, or attractive or acceptable teachers. Got it? So you must maintain ego in your sound or in your voice. By ego, I mean that your sound must be strong enough, or it must be quite refreshing, or it must be heard till the final row of your class. The final row, or the students who are the backbenchers, or who are sitting in the final row of your class, they shall hear your sound quite, we can say, clearly. Got it? So this is again an important point, ego. And as you know that sound is playing quite important role in presentation, or we can say in teaching. And melodious sound or refreshing sound is quite an important factor in order to prove yourself a good teacher. Got it? So this is echo, or sound must be maintained quite, we can say, loudly, or we can say you must be having quite a strong voice or sound. And of course, you must not be monotonous. There is a term, we call it monotonous. By monotonous, we mean that when you are not maintaining rhythm in your sound. You must be, for example, including certain pauses. You must be having your pitch and frequency of your sound up and down. So in order to avoid this quality, I shall not call it quality, I shall just call it this defect, that you shall not be monotonous. Monotonous means when you are moving with a single rhythm, such as those who are presenting news in news channels. Got it? So you are a teacher. There are certain points in which you shall emphasize, you shall, we can say, strengthen your voice. There are other conditions in your class, during your class session, in which you shall just, for example, decrease your sound, or you shall talk or speak quite warmly. Got it? So these are certain techniques of teaching that you shall maintain your voice. That is, it must be having quite a strong echo, and it must not be monotonous. And there, in certain, we can say, points, you must increase your voice. In other points, you shall decrease your voice. Got it? This is another point. Okay, then comes feeding. By feeding, literally, feeding means when you are providing food in the mouth of children, neonates, infants. This means we call it feeding, in order to nourish infants. Over here, by feeding, I mean with knowledge. Feeding with knowledge. So, in certain conditions, you must not degrade, for example, students. I'll be telling you people in this point, that is appreciation. So, you must not degrade or discourage your students. There are certain conditions you might have observed that whenever a student is not aware of any knowledge or any point, he or she is making quite innocent face. Got it? He or she will be making quite innocent face that, sorry, and his or her facial expression will tell you that, sorry, I'm not sure about this point, so kindly tell me. So you must be, in a sense, a psychiatrist, got it? That we can say physician who is knowing the facial expressions. So you must be an important, we can say, a good psychiatrist in this sense, and you shall pick that message quite abruptly, that he or she is not knowing it. Then you'll have to feed that student with the knowledge and tell the answer of that question. Don't bother him or her ahead. Got it? So this is feeding. And in feeding, you, of course, around the clock, when you are teaching the students, you are feeding them with knowledge. But over here, by feeding, I mean that whenever a student is wanting, or he or she is desiring the answer from you. So you must read the facial expressions, and after that, you'll have to provide that data, that relevant data. Got it? Okay, then the final point, that is appreciation or reward, encouragement. Got it? Reward, of course, this is quite an important factor in order to motivate the students. Try to use attractive terms. Got it? Solid terms of reward and appreciation. That is, for example, wonderful, extraordinary. Got it? Excellent. You can do it, and so on. Got it? So these are the certain terms which are in the sense of reward. So don't degrade your students. Don't discourage them. Try to just constrict them. So use constructive terms in place of destructive terms. That, oh, you can do it, for example. So, okay, sit down. And you are giving them tough looks, and so on. Got it? These are never good, we can say, points regarding better teaching. Got it? So over here, appreciation means reward, encouragement, motivation. So use attractive terms, as I told you, that is extraordinary, for example, tremendous, fabulous, excellent, you can do that, and so on. And try to just provide them with a candy, in a sense. Got it? And reward can be in the form of gifts, it can be in the form of words. Got it? Whatsoever is available, try to just provide them to students. Got it? So this was our today's lecture regarding techniques of teaching. So in my next video, I'll be teaching you people the further, we can say, techniques or tricks or points regarding a better teaching method. Got it? So be with me. Thank you for your attention. Allah Hafiz.